From the towering sequoia trees to the brilliance of human intellect, from deadly mushrooms to microscopic bacteria, there exists a remarkable commonality. All life on Earth is carbon-based. Despite carbon not being the most abundant or stable element, it permeates our cells, comprising 20% of our bodies while constituting less than 1% of Earth's mass. The question arises, why did life choose carbon over more abundant alternatives like oxygen and silicon? Join us as we unravel the logic behind nature's selection, exploring the captivating significance of carbon, the very foundation of life. There are 94 naturally occurring elements on the periodic table. With so many choices available, why is everything based on carbon? The answer lies in three key factors: complexity, abundance, and stability. Let's start with complexity. Carbon possesses a unique ability to form complex molecular structures required for the intricate chemistry that life demands. This stems from the foundation of chemistry, which lies in physics, particularly quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics reveals that certain electron orbital configurations are more energetically favorable and thus more stable. The most stable electron configurations are found in the noble gases, located on the far right side of the periodic table. These elements possess complete outer shells of electron, representing the lowest energy state an atom can achieve. Consequently, noble gases are chemically stable and inert, rarely interacting with other atoms to form molecules. The reason noble gases, and not other elements, exhibit this stability is due to having the right number of protons to fill their electron shells completely. Chemistry, at its core, seeks to attain the most energetically efficient state in a system, the state of lowest energy. Filling the outermost shell completely, as seen in noble gases, is the preferred configuration. Some atoms achieve this by sharing electrons with other atoms, forming covalent chemical bonds. The periodic table organizes elements, allowing us to determine the maximum number of bonds an element can form based on its column. Starting from the left column, each subsequent column can form one additional bond, up to the fourth column with a maximum of 4 bonds. Carbon resides in this fourth column, possessing a total of 6 electrons, with 4 in its outer shell. To fill its outermost shell, carbon requires 4 additional electrons, reaching a total of 8, akin to the stable noble gas, neon. Carbon can share up to 4 electrons with other atoms, forming covalent bonds and enhancing its stability. This versatility renders carbon highly adaptable. Imagine if Lego bricks could connect on 4 sides instead of 2. Building things would become significantly easier. Similarly, carbon can form strong and stable bonds with up to 4 other atoms, including other carbon atoms. This remarkable feature enables carbon to construct complex molecules, a necessity for the intricate chemical processes vital for life. Carbon-based molecules can form diverse structures, including long, non-repetitive chains, closed rings, and bonds with varying strength, single, double, or triple with other elements. This diversity results in millions of possible configurations, making carbon uniquely capable of participating in a vast array of chemical reactions. Carbon's ability to form long, stable polymer chains is especially crucial. These chains can carry extensive information, as exemplified by DNA. DNA encapsulates all the information that defines living organisms, including ourselves. The 4 nucleotides comprising DNA's building blocks are intricate, and carbon's capacity to handle complexity makes it the backbone of life. In contrast, other elements fall short in terms of interest and versatility. Oxygen, despite being the most abundant element on Earth, can only form 2 bonds. Once it bonds with 2 other atoms, its capabilities are limited. Oxygen cannot create the intricate scaffolds of complex molecules that carbon can. While elements like boron can form 3 bonds and potentially complex structures, Their scarcity renders them unsuitable as the backbone of life. Availability is a vital consideration, and carbon, with its abundance and intricate capabilities, emerges as the natural choice for the foundation of all life on Earth. The second crucial factor that contributed to carbon selection as the basis for life is its abundance. Carbon is not only versatile, but also widely available in the universe. When we examine the top five most abundant elements in our solar system, we find that hydrogen, helium, oxygen, carbon, and nitrogen rank among the highest. Interestingly, four out of these top five elements in the solar system also happen to be among the top five elements that make up the human body. Oxygen, the most abundant element in our bodies, plays a crucial role in respiration and energy production. Carbon, ranking second in abundance, forms the backbone of organic molecules and is the foundation of life's complex chemistry. Hydrogen and nitrogen, the third and fourth most abundant elements in our bodies, are essential components of numerous biological molecules, such as DNA, proteins, and carbohydrates. Calcium, the fifth most abundant element, contributes to the structure and functioning of our bones. The correlation between the abundance of these elements in the universe and their presence in our bodies provides compelling evidence for carbon's significance in life. The abundance of carbon facilitates the formation and stability of diverse organic compounds, enabling the intricate chemistry required for life's processes. Furthermore, abundance plays a vital role in the building blocks of life. Having an ample supply of carbon allows for the creation of complex molecular structures, long polymer chains, and intricate arrangements of atoms. Just like constructing a castle requires an abundance of Lego bricks, the abundance of carbon enables the construction of the intricate molecular machinery of life. The third factor that determines the suitability of an element for life is stability, particularly in terms of bond stability. Carbon stability makes it an excellent choice for the backbone of organic molecules. To understand this, we need to compare carbon with its neighboring element on the periodic table, silicon. Silicon shares some similarities with carbon. Both elements have four valence electrons, enabling them to form four covalent bonds. Silicon is also abundant on Earth, and there is more silicon present than carbon. However, despite these similarities, silicon does not serve as the basis for life's chemistry. The key difference lies in the strength of the bonds formed by carbon and silicon. The electron configuration of carbon places its four valence electrons in the second shell, closer to the nucleus. This positioning results in strong and stable covalent bonds when carbon atoms bond with other elements or with themselves. On the other hand, silicon's four valence electrons occupy the third shell, farther away from the nucleus. As a consequence, the bonds formed by silicon are weaker and less stable than those formed by carbon. The stability of carbon bonds is essential for the structural integrity of organic molecules. It allows the carbon-based molecules to withstand the conditions under which other parts of the molecule may break their bonds and react chemically with other molecules. In contrast, a molecular scaffold made from silicon would be more prone to disintegration, hindering the intricate chemical processes necessary for life. Comparatively, the bond strength of silicon bonds is 196 kilojoules per mole, while carbon bonds exhibit a higher strength of 334 kilojoules per mole. This significant difference in bond strength highlights the superior stability of carbon-based compounds and their ability to withstand the diverse chemical reactions that occur within living systems. Considering these factors, carbon emerges as the ideal element for life's chemistry. Its versatility, abundance, and stability make it uniquely suited for forming the complex molecules and intricate structures essential for life's processes. While silicon and other elements have their own unique properties and applications, they lack the combination of characteristics necessary to support the diverse chemistry and complexity observed in living organisms. Let's explore the factors that make carbon the perfect element for life, while considering the possibility of alternative forms of life. When we narrow down the elements based on their chemical properties and abundance, we are left with carbon, nitrogen, and silicon. However, if we further refine the selection by considering the ability to form strong single bonds and create a sturdy molecular backbone, carbon emerges as the clear winner. It possesses the ideal combination of abundance, the capacity to form complex structures, and stable bonds with other carbon atoms. While carbon reigns supreme for life on Earth, we shouldn't dismiss the possibility of silicon-based life forms existing on other planets. Under suitable conditions, these alternative life forms could arise. In fact, we can even imagine life based on elements like germanium, tin, or lead. However, as we move to heavier elements, their scarcity becomes a significant challenge. Germanium, for example, is orders of magnitude less abundant than carbon, and tin is even rarer. Our planet, with its specific pressures and temperatures, provides an environment conducive to life forms that rely on liquid water as a solvent and carbon-based molecules that form stable backbones for biological chemistry. Extremes in temperature can disrupt chemical transport or cause carbon polymer chains to break easily. Therefore, carbon remains the dominant choice for life as we know it, except in extreme environments. While we may not have concrete evidence of extraterrestrial life, we must maintain an open-minded perspective regarding the conditions in which life could potentially exist. Titan, one of Saturn's moons, hosts lakes of ethane and methane. These liquids, like water on Earth, could potentially serve as solvents for different types of life forms under different temperatures and pressures. In such scenarios, alternative elements may prove more conducive to life. As we contemplate the remarkable nature of carbon-based life on Earth, and the tantalizing prospect of alternative forms of life in the universe, let us ponder this question. Could there be undiscovered chemical systems or elemental foundations that give rise to life in ways we have yet to comprehend? Like, share, comment, and watch more content like this here.